what do you think people have on their minds after leaving the show, or what would you like them to have on their mind?
We really want people to leave with a sense of unity, that they were standing next to someone that they never met before, but that person was picking them up and taking care of them. And you know, that's a powerful statement. Everybody is there for the right reason, regardless of color of skin, sexual orientation, whether you're straight or gay, you know, fat or skinny, tall or short, it doesn't matter. We're all here for the same reason. The things in this world that try to bring us down, you know, whether it be turning on the television every day and hearing about war and hearing about violence, it's important for us to create a space and a time that is the opposite of that. If you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear some flowers in your hair.
Do you think people are changing their minds because of your music and your lyrics?
I mean, I know that it sounds arrogant to say yes. We know, just based on the emails we get and MySpace messages and people coming to the shows and us meeting them, that sometimes views get changed. And a lot of times people will criticize a band like us for preaching to the choir, that everybody already knows these things. But it's very rare that we get to be in a place where we get to celebrate these ideas and these facts. If it's cliche to have our own space, then let it be cliche. Billy Bragg, who is a great hero of ours, he talks about the first time he saw The Clash often. And he saw The Clash at Rock Against Racism, which is a big festival in London. And he said that he was going to work every day and seeing racism happen in his job and seeing people of different color of skin being treated poorly. And then he went to this show and he didn't give a damn what the band were saying. He didn't care about The Clash playing. He was just looking around and he said, all these people don't agree with racism. I'm not alone in my hatred of this hatred. So when we play a song that's about unity and everybody's clapping together, we hope that people are looking around and saying, like, wow, this is powerful. This is bigger than the band. This is bigger than me. This is all of us.
You are involved in a lot of organizations. How do you choose them?
Well, I think that it has to be something that's close to us, and you know, there's a lot of important issues in this world. You have to choose the battles that are important to you, so that when you talk about them and sing about them and create dialogue with other people about them, that you know what you're talking about and it's honest and it's real. You can't just say, you know, save the whales and not really have any information to back up the plight of the whale. You know what I mean? Like, I'm for animal rights, but, you know, only animal rights that I specifically know about. And you know, if someone wants to teach me about something and inform me, I'm more than happy to hear it. But, you know, when it comes to the organizations that we back, it 9 times out of 10 comes down to an education process on that issue, and then realizing that it's important enough to us that we would like to share it, you know. A lot of people come to us with a lot of things, but unfortunately, we're just 4 guys, you know? There are many other bands out there carrying different torches than us and championing different issues than us, and, you know, that's great, too. Seems every station.